For Tamika Catchings, it's been a career-long journey to the WNBA's Most Valuable Player Award. Five previous times, she finished either second or third in the voting. Persistence has defined Catchings ever since her childhood. As a young girl, she had to fight through the pain of growing up different from everybody else.
When she was 4 or 5 years old, we took her to the doctor because her hearing had gotten worse and worse.
There you go. How you doing?
Also, the fact that she couldn't hear all the sounds, there was a slight speech impediment. So she had to begin wearing hearing aids. We all know how brutal kids can be when they see someone that's different than themselves. And she reached a point where she started trying to figure out how she could go about getting rid of these hearing aids.
I just got so frustrated with getting made fun of. And I remember, like, every day I would go home crying. So one day on the way to school, I remember taking my hearing aids off and chucking them, you know, in a field. Basketball was something that no matter what, no matter who made fun of me, no matter what happened in my life, it was something that I could retreat to. I mean, I was still different, but now I was different, but I was good at something.
With the third pick of the 2001 WNBA draft, the Indiana Fever select Tamika Catchings from the University of Tennessee.
Here's Catchings, what a nice move up and inside and scores. Boy, has she been worth the wait.
That's the way Catchings plays, 100% every time she steps between the lines.
Catchings made an immediate impact as the WNBA's Rookie of the Year.
Tamika Catchings, if there is a superwoman, we are seeing it tonight.
White with a pass inside Catchings. Great tip pass. What an athletic play.
When anybody talks about some of the elite players in the WNBA, Tamika Catchings' name always is at the top of my list and many other players' list.
She's something special.
Tamika became known as the league's best stopper. No one has matched her record of 4 Defensive Player of the Year awards.
Her nickname is the animal. She gets after it 110% both ends of the floor for 40 minutes. It's hard to come by players like that.
There's a reason Tamika Catchings is Defensive Player of the Year in the WNBA, and it's because of steals just like that.
Look at Catchings block that shot.
Get ready to run. Get ready to run. Work out, baby. All about working out.
True to her form, Tamika's persistence hasn't allowed her to rest.
I keep pushing myself by being determined to be the best. Every single year, players are getting younger, they're getting faster, they're getting smarter.
Tamika Catchings is very determined, highly competitive.
We can beat this team. We got to believe in it. We got to work hard together. We had the fourth quarter, and we had overtime. We let it go. Let's go. Beaver on three. 1, 2, 3.
Beaver.
Got to find that edge. And, you know, I think for me, just becoming a smarter player and more effective with everything that I do.
Stripped from behind by Catchings, out of bounds, it's Indiana ball. Tamika Catchings coming up with a great defensive play.
This season, Catchings entered elite company during All-Star Weekend, being named one of the WNBA's top 15 players in history. But it wasn't until late September that she finally stood alone. Now the young girl, who never stopped fighting, has become an MVP with unfinished business.
When you think of a legacy and you think of all the things that you've been able to accomplish, at the end of the day, when you hang up your shoe and you walk away from the game, you're characterized on how many championships you've won. Just like, ugh! Like, I gotta get them that. It's cool to be a part of the top 15, you know, with everything else, but I gotta get a championship. I need that. I want it.